WRC, WRC-FM, Washington.
Now WRC Radio presents some Halloween tips, do's and don'ts for Halloween. And here's our WRC Halloween expert, Jack O'Lantern.
Hey, thank you very much, Willard Scott. And now, here's Jack O'Lantern's don'ts for Halloween. Item 1, don't sing Christmas carols on Halloween. It's not the appropriate season of the year. Item 2, don't have turkey and dressing for Halloween dinner because it's not the proper holiday for that. And finally, if you want to meet a couple of spooks, then by all means, listen to the Joy Boys on Halloween night. Boy, they're the weirdest guys you ever saw in your life.
The Joy Boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro. We are the Joy Boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro.
The Joy Boys show for this Friday evening. This is Ed Walker here.
Willard Scott over here. Georgie Brewington behind the console. Bobby Shenton bobbing for apples behind the Ampex. And there he goes down for the third apple. His Adam's apple. He got it right in the bowl of water over there. And, of course, our good old standby, Arthur Page,
yeah,
the singing rage.
That's me.
Wonderful to have you all with us.
With my eyes wide open, I'm dreaming.
Now for WRC Extra, here's our WRC Poet Laureate, Mr. Jonathan Apple, with a poem for us today.
Good evening, and thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Don't be nervous, don't be mean, just because it's Halloween.
Hey, that's good. Now, Jonathan, have you a poet special air for us today?
A romantic poem.
Very good.
I know, my dear, you're wondering why I hit you in the eye with a pumpkin pie.
Now, in closing, here's Jonathan Apple, who will say...
Goodbye now.
Coming up on our show this evening, we will interview the Yellow Ghost, and a very appropriate one for Halloween Eve type thing here. Our program is on a Halloween Eve. WRC's Roundtable of Knowledge will be with us today, and Mr. Fix-It will fix something for us, right?
Oh, I think so.
George? Have you got a record?
No.
Okay. Art?
Yeah, I got one.
Okay, you play it.
Okay.
Bobby, quit bobbing for Apple. That's a type of an ending that drives a disc jockey crazy. He sits there and the engineer, they both wait until the thing ends, and then usually when it is, a record sticks, and Freddie announces drinking coffee, and he... forget. Would you...
Happy birthday to you.
Shopping's a lark at Langley Park, and the birthday party is still on. Langley Park, Maryland, where they're celebrating with great big savings galore. Langley Park, thank you. The National Broadcasting Company presents The Adventures of the Yellow Ghost, the story of John Singleton Nosby, CSA.
We took our men from Texas, from Kentucky, from the backwoods and the plains. What we lacked in number, we really lacked in brains. Both Rebs and Yankee strangers, they called us Nosby's Rangers. Yellow Ghost is what they called me. Chicken Little is my name.
The true, exciting story of the Yellow Ghost, the Confederate legendary character of the old Civil War days. As our story opens, we find ourselves high up on the Blue Ridge Mountains, looking out over the Loudoun Valley. It is near Halloween Eve, and there's a mystery and an eeriness in the air. As our story opens, the wind is whistling up through the Loudoun Valley as a hoot owl screeches up in a tree.
Well, men...
Excuse me, our sound effects man has a cough, if you'd excuse.
I noticed that.
As our story opens, Major Nosby speaks to his men as he says,
Men, seems to be a very quiet night. Not much happening. Let's all relax around the campfire. What do you say?
Yes, good idea.
Would someone please throw another log on the fire?
All right, Major.
Not Harry Log. He's the sergeant here. You threw him on the fire,
man. He's from Danville. We don't like him. Anybody from Danville is no good. That's what I always do.
Well, men, we don't have any apples to bob for. What would you like to do this evening?
Major?
Yes, Sergeant?
Begging your pardon, sir, but seeing it's Halloween like this, me and the boys were thinking maybe you being the Yellow Ghost and all that sort of jazz, And if you could tell us a ghost story, tell us something scary, tell us something mean and dirty about the Yankees.
All right, Sergeant. It all happened in New York.
Ooh, oh, man.
A bunch of the Yanks were hooping it up in the Malamute Saloon.
Sounds familiar, maybe.
They were sitting around a big table discussing their fate.
Ooh, yeah.
Yes, they were afraid of strikes in the ranks, fellas. They expected some foul play, and they didn't know exactly what to do.
What happened, did you?
Finally, they decided there was one man who could turn the tide for the Yanks.
What'd they do, did you?
They rehired Casey Stengel.
I lost money on the pennant this year anyway. Boy, I'm fed up with the whole thing, Major.
Our fame. Yellow Ghost is what they call me. Chicken Little is my name.
This has been a Kurt Pryor production.
We've been places, had a chance to roam. Here I
come. Susan Bennett there, or Susan, what's her name? Barrett? Susie Q, a little thing called California. Here I am. I know it's come. I'm just 15 minutes after 7 is the time here at the National Broadcasting Company. Over at Broadcast House, it's 2:30. The clock is busted. I have a word now for Safeway. Could I have your ear, please? Thank you. Vote for Safeway. A landslide of values is yours this week at Safeway. With a firm platform on values, the best meal ticket is offering for your selection a wide variety of candidates, fully guaranteed to satisfy. At Safeway, for instance, you'll find prices that are always favorite sums. Would you like to check the ballot for the candidates now? I have it right here. Well, for instance, like Skylark Power Pack Protein Bread with lyocene. So delicious. Added to provide twice the protein efficiency of ordinary white bread for bodybuilding and provide the same protein efficiency as meat and milk and other dairy products. Regular price, 29 cents a loafer. This week, Skylark Power Pack Protein Bread is featured at the Get Acquainted price of only 19 cents a loaf. There are many other fine candidates for you to select from in your nearby Safeway store. Remember, quality and value are yours when you elect to shop Safeway. Vote for Safeway. Shop at Safeway, where food is first. And remember, too, please, will you, to vote in the national elections on November the 8th. A good citizen hint from Safeway. Time now, 17 minutes after 7.
Yes, well, I think that
the National Broadcasting Company presents the WRC Round Table of Knowledge. Each day at this time, once a week on Friday, we present our WRC Round Table of Knowledge with the idea in mind of promoting semantics so that you will know more about the everyday common words you use in everyday language. Now, let me get the attention of our panel members, and I shall introduce you, our audience, to each panel member. Panel members, may I have your attention, please, there? Yes, thank you very much.
That's right.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
First of all, representing the Chicago Institute for the Abolishment of Chicago, Mr. Orson Meyer.
Good evening, Chicago haters. It's great to be with you again.
Miss Anonym, formerly the Miss Synonym of 1932, now with the East-West-North-South Word Study Group for Word Preservation.
Thank you for those kind words of introduction.
And finally, the eminent and distinguished gentleman, the professor of neo-anthrosemantics of Wiesbaden, Germany, is missing. He's not here. Has anybody seen the professor?
No, I haven't seen him.
Have you seen the professor?
Good riddance,
I
say.
Why do you say good riddance? I was a little late. There was a traffic jam downtown there when I tried some on toast, and it was delicious. I tell you.
Somebody pulled your elevator cable, I think, Professor.
Did you introduce me yet in the style?
Professor Heinrich Van Lyne.
Yeah, that's me. Yeah,
all right.
There.
Now, panel members, we're all here. Ready?
Yes.
Put your coffee cups down, please.
I didn't even get none yet.
It's cold. Whether we get some effort.
Well, all right.
Are you ready for today's word?
Yeah, boy.
All right. It's the sound of the bell, today's word. Please. Oh, I'm sorry. It was near you, Miss Nim. Today's word is, are you ready?
Yes.
Today's word is pumpkin.
Pumpkin?
Pumpkin.
Pumpkin, yes.
Being Halloween,
of course.
Pumpkin, yes.
Yeah, pumpkin.
All right. The first question is addressed to you, Miss Nim.
Yes. Well,
what is the derivation of the word pumpkin, and what does it mean to you?
Well, it's It's a terminology used to describe people from the sticks, a country pumpkin, they say sometimes.
No, Miss Nim, no.
What do you think?
That's a country bumpkin, I believe.
Is that right, bumpkin?
Yeah, bumpkin, B-U-M-P, bumpkin.
I think I can solve the
very
dilemma.
Good. Mr. Meyer, would you tell us what you know about the word pumpkin? What does it mean? What's its derivation?
Certainly, I've had my hand up here.
I noticed it was up there. Hey, let's put it down. It's been stuck.
Ow. Thank you.
Your hand.
Actually, it's an old proverb, and it goes like this. The pump can bring water from the well, but it can't drink it for you.
Would you repeat that again?
So the pump can bring water from the well.
The pump can bring water from the well,
you.
But it can't drink it.
Well,
that's
stretching a point
bad,
there,
really.
Isn't it? I mean, after all.
Professor, we're depending upon you for the scientific explanation.
Always, it relies on my superior knowledge to answer these questions.
Pumpkin, what does it mean, Professor?
It's used in scientific experiments to measure the weather.
The weather?
Yeah, Lord, it's used to tell you what the temperature is. I talked to Frank Forrester and a lot of the weathermen. They tell me that they measure the temperature by checking to see when the frost is on the pumpkin.
We've been visiting with Mr. Orson Meyer, Miss Anna Nim.
Pumpkin. That's Oz Bodkin.
Finally, the
you?
Eminent professor of neoanthrosomatics, Heinrich Van Leyden.
I'm sorry I even showed up for this.
Be listening again next week when our program will come to you from Studio 3. Let's move the furniture over there now instead of next week.
Good
okay,
night,
fellas,
all.
Can we take it all over there next week? Okay.
Am I blue?
Thank you and good evening. Also, Yankee Ho. It's Am I Blue, done for us by Vic Damone this evening. Your Rambler dealer, you know, has a completely new line of 1961 Ramblers. And each new Rambler carries a full year or a 12,000-mile warranty, whichever comes first. We hope you'll come first and see that beautiful new Rambler. See your Rambler dealer and see him this evening. It'd be an excellent night. Go up and trick-or-treat him. Tell him you want a Rambler. You poke him in the mouth. Okay, the National Broadcasting Company and WRC Radio, in cooperation with Johnson & Swanson, the world's greatest manufacturer of first-aid kits, brings you another visit with Mr. Fixit, radio's original do-it-yourself program. Today, as we join Mr. Fixit, we find him in his basement workshop, slaving over a hot table, as we say there. Ahoy there, Mr.
Ahoy vey there, Willard Scott, and good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Wonderful to have you again on our program and to bring our portable microphone into your home, Mr.
Thank you. It's always a pleasure to have you visiting.
I noticed in your hands you have some delicate surgical tools, and apparently you're working over some sort of minute particle there.
That is correct. I don't want you to think for a minute that I'm studying medicine, because I'm not.
Put the surgical tool down for one moment.
Certainly.
So we can.
I'm studying a new scientific art here. It all came about when the kids wanted a jack-o'-lantern for Halloween.
I see.
And I thought, well, it's very obvious. You could go out and buy a pumpkin and cut it out and everything. That's kid stuff.
But
is
messy and a lot of work to scoop out a pumpkin and get the pumpkin goo all over you.
Yes, it is a trifle, yes.
Uh-huh. Cutting out the eyes and the nose and the mouth. And
I decided, why not do all this before the pumpkin grows?
Well, now, this is very interesting. How do you do that, Mr. Fixit?
By cutting out the eyes, the nose, and the mouth in the pumpkin seed.
Is that what those little things are down there?
That is correct. And then when the seed grows into a full-grown pumpkin, presto, you have a ready-made jack-o'-lantern.
It's an Italian pumpkin, a presto, isn't
it? That's right.
Let me see one of the seeds, please.
Would you just bend down here a little bit. I've got this high-powered microscope, you see.
Mm-hmm.
You can't do this with just the, pardon the expression, naked eye.
Ooh.
So yes. I take the small surgical instrument here, see? And there is a nose.
That's wonderful.
See? Now, we'll work on the eyes.
Okay.
There's one eye and another eye.
Wonderful.
Now we got to carve out the mouth here. There, that's good. Got double chin, but that's all right.
Well, looks now, like me, Mr. Fixit.
Now then, you see,
the pumpkin seed is no bigger than a dime, though.
That's right. Now the question is, how do you get this pumpkin seed to grow into a pumpkin immediately?
Put it in the ground and wait for it.
That takes too long.
So what do you do?
Well, I have developed an Instarizer.
A what?
You make instant pumpkin.
How do you do this?
This is a special solution of Petty Ross Boromo Valley.
Swell.
And we just take the pumpkin seed and drop it into the solution, like that, and very shortly you'll have a full-grown pumpkin.
Will you look at that? I'll be darned.
There it is. There are the eyes. There's the nose. There's the mouth.
Only one thing wrong, Mr. Fiske.
What's that?
It's a watermelon.
A what? A watermelon?
Yes, not a pumpkin.
Well, so we got a green
jack-o'-lantern.
Somebody
sold you some wrong seeds
there.
We'll
save him and use it for St. Patrick's Day. So
we've been visiting with Radio's original do-it-yourselfer, Mr. Fixer.
When Irish
brought to you by Johnson
spring.
And Swanson,
sure,
the world's foremost manufacturer of first aid kits.
That's a cute looking
get those
thing,
pumpkins on the trunk, boys, and take them out and paint them yellow.
How do you like that?
There we go. Be listening again next week when you'll hear Mr. Fixer say... Well, that's Shearing, George, and the orchestra. That's the way his report card used to read when he was in school, and if I could write a book, then I would be out of this crummy business. I would like to, Ben Asker, the promotion director of the station, Charlotte Walsh, our beloved Kimo Sabe, has asked me to announce that. Don't forget, daylight savings time will cease to be as of midnight Sunday, or Saturday, is it? Saturday or Tuesday? No, Monday. Sunday night, we will no longer have it. But don't forget, Saturday night's the night you do it. You put the clock ahead 1 hour or back 1 half hour. If it's 2 hours before, you put the clock ahead. Don't forget the clock. Call the out. Get the whole thing. Work the thing. If you can do your best, please. Would you call them and see what we can... I don't understand why.
We are the joy boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro. We are the joy boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro.
And so all the water is drained out of the birdbath again for another week. We'd like to thank our producer, Richard the Lionhearted, our director, Marco Polo, scripts and special material by Queen Isabella, and our lawyer, Clarence Darrow.
We sure lost another one, boys.
Thanks to George Brington, Bobby Shenton, and Arthur Page. This show is heard by our
armed forces overseas.
Cue the boys to sing again.
Go, boys.
We are the joy boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro. We are the joy boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro.
An advertising man's wife gets sick of television commercials tonight on NBC.
Mom! Hey, Mom! Look! No cavities!
Look again, you little monster.
7:30. Morgan.
This is Morgan Beatty bringing you news of the world. Tonight in the headlines, the big story...
We take you now to a courtroom where the jury's about to render a verdict.
Can we have order in the court, please?
Order, please.
Will the gentleman, the foreman of the jury, please rise and face the court? Have the gentlemen of the jury reached a verdict?
We have, Your Honor.
I see. And what is your verdict?
It is the opinion of this jury that the court be adjourned for the next 25 minutes.
For what purpose do you wish adjournment?
For the purpose of listening to the Joy Boys radio show, which is on WRC at 7
o'clock. Your Honor, I object.
Objection overruled.
Out of place.
No, that's not right.
The joy boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro. We are the joy boys of radio. We chase electrons to and fro.
Time for the Joy Boys show for Monday night. This is Ed Walker here.
Willard Scott here. Bobby Shetton on the door. Little old mystery man behind the board. And, of course, Arthur Page is there, as always, behind the consulate.
Yeah, that's right.
Coming up on our show, Sammy Skin will perform for you this evening.
Good.
Also, we will present memos from management, radio's beloved program. And Arthur Codfish will finally be along on our program. It looks like a very...
Greetings and salutations. Once again, it's Monday.
For some people it's blue, but it's my fun day.
Hey, the dulcet pear-shaped tones indicate that Jonathan Affle, our WRC Poet Laureate, is with us, and Jonathan has a poem for WRC fans all over the world.
Yes.
Jonathan, would you like to...
Thank you very much. Mother, have some hamburgers, or at least some weenies, for all the trick-or-treaters on Halloweenies.
Hey, that's sort of a double rotundant there, but...
What's that?
Now, one more poem, all right?
Yes.
Jonathan Affle and one more poem.
Said the oyster to the stew, I got out of bed for you.
Hey, now, now in closing, here's Jonathan Affle to say,
au revoir.
Isn't that lovely music? We play the best music in town here on the Joy Boys Show. We think most of our fans agree. Hey, I've got some pretty exciting news for you.
Me?
Yes, for you, dear. One of the great features of a Volkswagen is its rugged construction. Boy, just as solid as a rock there. And lots of owners have claimed over 100,000 miles of carefree driving. But each one, believe, yeah, thank, there goes another Volkswagen just being sold. Driven out there. Yes, everybody loves their Volkswagen. And it really means that you can take care of your car and your car will take care of you. This program assures the Volkswagen owner of top-notch service and repair work. Helps assure him his Volkswagen will continue to perform at maximum efficiency and economy through Volkswagen preventative maintenance. Just one more reason why Volkswagen is the ideal car for you. Stop in at Capital Car Sales Limited at their new address, 1401 Rhode Island Avenue, Northeast. An authorized Volkswagen dealer. There's another Volkswagen being sold, so you test drive a Volkswagen right now. Look over the new facilities. You'll be convinced a Volkswagen owner has a right to be bragging about his Volkswagen. 9 out of 10 Volkswagen owners say,
Ja, wie schön du bist, schön gewesen, wie flitten.
I see, ladies and gentlemen, according to our program schedule, it's time for the music of Sammy Skin, his drums, and his recitation.
Very so nice, so he should be.
Sammy,
hi,
open the door.
Everybody.
Here he comes. Dragging behind him his bongos, his timpani, his bass, and his bongos, his tom-tom. Here comes Sammy Skin, sliding into position in front of microphone 2, over there, just behind the door. Let him get his... Maraca set there, his wood block.
Like cucaracha,
looks like it. From the rehearsal, it sounds like we're in for a little bit of a Latin flavor, right, Sammy?
No, I just thought I'd fool you there.
Well, you gave me your real bum start on Halloween.
I'm a pretty bum player, actually. Now, tonight, I am going to satisfy a long-time desire that I've had.
How's that? You're quitting on the air.
No, no, I've always wanted to be a reciter of poems on the air.
You mean a la the old Sunday Serenade with
that's right.
Wayne slinging his musical
yeah,
group,
that's yeah. It. And, you know, where he had the orchestra and then he'd recite these poems.
That's right.
Unfortunately, it's not within our monetary means to have an orchestra.
So you...
I'm going to recite poetry accompanied by myself on the drums.
Very good. Well, we happen to know that you're going to do this, so we got a particularly bassy microphone for you. Would you take your position so you can speak very lowly into this bassy mic?
Thank you.
I'll move out of the way over to this little salt shaker over here.
We're going to do this evening the very famous Melody of Love, as it was done by Franklin McCormick many years ago. Now, let me just take my place at the drums here. Uh-oh. All right.
Use the bassy mic.
Why do I love you? I love you not only for what you are, but for what I am when I am with you. I love you for ignoring the possibilities of the fool in me and for laying firm hold on the possibilities of the good in me. I love you because you're helping me to make of the lumber of my life not a tavern, but a temple. And of the words of my everyday, not a reproach, but a psalm. Why do I love you? I love you because you have done more than any creed to make me happy. You have done it without a word, without a sign, without a touch. You have done it by just being yourself. Perhaps, after all, that is what love means. You like it? It's very touching. I hate to see a man cry, really.
Come on. Beautiful, Sam.
Thank you. I kind of liked it myself.
Eddie, would you sign off the show?
I don't think I can.
Bobby, would you sign up? Art.
Don't look at me.
You sign off.
I can't do it.
Calling Perky to Page. Perky! Perky, would you...
I can't. I'm crying.
Here's the script.
Join us again next week for another visit with Sammy Skin.
So beautiful.
Our drummer. Good night, folks.
He was so...
Sail along, silvery moon, to my love again.
No, ma'am, we're not sick. No, nobody's sick. Oh, excuse me, we're on the air. That was Andy Williams, and two selections by Andy Williams. Excuse me, I have a lady on the phone. No, ma'am. No, we're not sick. We're fine. Thank you very much for calling. You're very sweet. Yes, that's right. We played two Andy Williams records back to back. Now, there's no payola involved. We just like Andy Williams. You're the manager's who? Oh, wonderful. Well, thank you for enjoying the show. WPOT, wonderful. Well, thank you. Yeah, wonderful. We think they're great. Thank you, ma'am, yes. She couldn't understand why we were playing two songs back to back. It is sort of a first, but we're Andy Williams fans, and they're here, the wonderful new compact Ramblers for 1961. New styling, new comfort, and engineering features. See them all right now at your Rambler dealers. 21 minutes after 7.
And now, Mother Goose, the greatest name in memo pads, brings you Memos from Management. Mother Goose, the reinforced memo pad for angry executives, brings you Memos from Management. Remember, men, when you care enough to write with zest, use a Mother Goose memo pad. They're the best. And now it's with great pleasure that we share with you a few of our inner office Memos from Management. First of all, Memo 376-L from the cafeteria supervisor to members of the night crew.
Recently, a sandwich machine has been installed near the other vending machines in the lower level of the building. However, it has come to our attention that the engineering department could not leave well enough alone. It seems that someone attempted to automate the sandwich machine so that when the sandwich came out, the coffee and one candy bar would also drop out of the other machines. However, the piece of equipment necessary to automate these machines is the same that is used to put the TV slide identifying the station on the air. Last night, at 10 o'clock sharp, in place of the 10 o'clock Channel 4 slide and station break, two ham sandwiches, one Hershey bar, a cup of black coffee, plus the unwashed hand of one of the engineers with a Coolidge High School ring on his left index finger appeared on the TV screens of thousands of Washington area homes. Please, if you must continue this practice, at least wash your hands before each meal.
Next, Memo 555555 to all newsmen from the building supervisor.
Being adult men and women, and at this crucial time, I feel that all of us must know the importance upon acting our age. We in this department are well aware that the elections only happen once each 4 years, and that only a few newsmen can be used for the more select jobs of covering the election returns on election night. Would the guilty newsmen who did not get jobs on election night and who have been writing things on the side of the building like Huntley Brinkley Go Home and Morgan Beatty is a Fink please refrain from this juvenile action? We will need the cooperation of all of you Let's try and cooperate. Thank you, building supervisor.
Join us again next week for more memos from management brought to you by Mother Goose Memo Pads. Remember, men, when you want to write a memo to ball someone out, get a Mother Goose Memo Pad and get the lead out.
The preceding was recorded on Mother Goose reversible tape. Ben Hur, winner of 11 Academy Awards. He didn't work here, does he? Oh, no. All seats reserved. Evening performance every night. Matinees on Wednesday, Saturday, and Sunday. Tickets are now available at the Warner Theater for Ben Hur. You see, we got so many new employees, I wasn't sure that...
And now, Aunt Cindy's Sauerkraut. The only sauerkraut shredded by hand brings you Arthur Codfish Time. Yes, remember, Aunt Cindy's, the sauerkraut that is walked on by human feet to stamp it down in the barrel. And now, here he is, Arthur, the old krauthead codfish.
So blue, like the mountains, I'm blue just for you. Atty-tighty Scooby-Doo, and let me put the old thing down here.
Colleen, Ed, give me just a little taste of Aunt Cindy's sauerkraut.
Here you are, Arthur. Delicious.
There's a nail in here.
That's from the barrel, Arthur.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
Excuse me. I thought she did it by hand. I thought she must have...
Fingernail, yes. The teleprompter isn't too visible this morning, Arthur.
Golly bumps, it's nice in this...
Are you having a pleasant Halloween Eve on the farm,
Very
Arthur?
Very strange, Meatball. You know, when we were little son of a guns, little kids...
Yes?
We used to go out and do little pranks, like we'd turn over apples or leave... milk bottles full of water on somebody's door.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. We never did anything vicious nor malicious.
That's right, Arthur.
Never malicious never or malicious. Vicious.
That's right, Arthur.
Somebody came by my farm last night, and you know what they took, Meatball?
No, what did they take, Arthur?
They took a silo.
The whole silo?
The whole 85-foot-tall silo holding 700,000 cubic bushels of anything that you can shove in there.
That's not very funny, is it, Arthur?
It's not too amusing if you own the silo.
The nerve of someone to take a thing like that.
It's pretty disgusting, and if I find the culprit, believe me, there's going to be a real niche to be paid.
Well, that's terrible. Well, Arthur, we have no music today. The Magoo sisters did not show up, Arthur.
Well, the girls need a little rest.
Yes, so we have no music this morning, Arthur.
Well, I think you and I might render one. What
you and
say?
I? Render, meaning to tear apart.
What is here's the music. You know, this
here's
is...
a wonderful
Call
song.
Call Me Madam. Irving
yes.
Berlitz wrote this
yes.
for the School
that's,
of Music.
That's a wonderful song here called You're Just in Love, Arthur.
Shall we try it?
You go first, and I'll come in with you.
One, two, three.
You don't need in life, and there's no
and it's not
one
so
there.
Surprising. It's very strange that I feel
and
this
the
way.
Trees are bare.
Your heart goes pitter patter.
Arthur,
I know just
Arthur, I can't
what's
sing
the matter,
because
I know I've been. You didn't have to bust my uke, Meatball.
We were just ruining our ratings with that horrible singing, Arthur.
Let me see. I'll get some ad libs from the newspaper.
Read from the paper, Arthur.
Checking here. Old man 68 elopes with 1,500 women. It sounds very interesting. That's in the kicker of the day. Today's chuckle. Let me see. Hey, here's the classified section. Here's the classified section.
Yes.
Always usually little interesting tittlebits in the classified
yes,
section.
What was that man's name, Arthur, in that last story?
Warren somebody. Strike it something. Here is the... son of a gun. Look, hotline. Look at this.
What's this? What is it?
Says, for sale. Maybe I can buy this. 85-foot silo holding 700,000 cubic...
Arthur, I think it's about time for us to sign off.
This looks like my silo. It says contact Lexington 57... Lexington 573. That's your number. You stole my silo.
Well, you're late, Arthur.
You trick or treat. Come here.
You haven't paid
you got
me
the
in 2 years,
Here's
Arthur.
The treat.
I need your money. Oh.
Your heart goes pitter-patter. 1,500 women. I think I'll call them. Put the old... Hey, how come I broke the thing? It's still playing. Son of a gun. The miracles of this one. Elmer's glue is the one for you. So long, everybody. everybody. This is what's left of the radio network.
The Joy Boys of Radio. We chase electrons to and fro. We are the Joy Boys of Radio. We chase electrons to and fro.
And so they've let us out of our cage again for another evening. Thank you for this Monday. We are very grateful to you who listen all over the world. Thanks to Arthur Page. Thanks to Robert Shetton and our mystery engineer. This program came to you from the facilities of WRC-NBC in Washington, and it is heard by our armed forces overseas. Thank you and good evening.
We are the Joy Boys of Radio. We chase electrons to and fro. We are the Joy Boys of Radio. We chase electrons to and fro.
Mac McGarry interviews a fraternity man tonight over the NBC Radio Network. WRC, WRC-FM, NBC in Washington. At the tone, 7:30.